Got it. So welcome to the October 19th for everybody, Asia Pacific Community Call. I'm sharing my screen so you can see what's going on here. It's good to have everybody here. If you could add yourself to the minutes, that would be great. We don't have a huge agenda today. We'll see how long it takes to kind of go through. So I thought we could talk a little bit about just how to extend our presence in the Asia Pacific region. Yuhui, if you had any compass updates that you wanted to tell us about. And then I just thought we could spend a little bit of time. I always like to use this meeting to talk about chaos updates, just so everybody kind of knows what we're doing. And then, of course, if you want to add your anything to the agenda, please do that. And I have no idea what osmanthus is.
Rare.
No. Now, we might have a similar tree. It might just be a different name.
Actually, yeah. I translate through the Google translation. I don't quite know.
You have a picture of it that you could put in here?
I do have that.
So I don't know. We don't have a lot of fragrant fall trees in the U.S. Elizabeth, do you know any fragrant trees in the fall?
I don't think so. I think most of them are spring.
Yeah, I think most of them are spring for us as well. So I was thinking like cherry blossoms, crab apples, pear trees, magnolias. Those are all spring. Anywho, if you have a picture, Yui.
Yeah, I can't.
You got a job to put it in the minutes. All right. So one of the things I'd like to talk about today is how to kind of expand or extend our presence in the Asia Pacific region. And I mean, this group that's on the call is great, but I'd like to think about how we could, say, include members from Japan or Korea or even Australia in these calls. And I'm not sure, I put down a few ideas here. So there is Open Source Summit Japan, which I know that I'm guessing none of us are going to this year. Is anybody by chance going to Open Source Summit Japan?
No, actually. I don't think I can join it locally. Okay. But do we have any topics represented from CHAOSS?
No, but I think if we had something, we might be able to do like a birds of a feather session. You know what I mean? Like like an unconference part of it. So, I mean, if I looked at the schedule, like they might have just like breakout sessions. I haven't looked at the schedule deeply.
It's 2 day session? Or?
Yeah, probably 2 day session. Yep, it's a 2 day session. So, I mean, it doesn't have to happen. It's something that I was thinking about. Like, if we could start to connect with events that are occurring, whether they're
maybe you can scroll down. I noticed someone I'm familiar with.
Keep going.
No, here. I noticed that it's something about spawn.
Swarm?
Spawn.
Oh, spawn.
S-B-O. Scroll up. I see something. I can check. I can check later. Because we do have some teams to have some related topics, about AI data.
Okay.
So, okay, you can see that. I noticed that there's Huawei's name.
Is Huawei here in the?
in the bottom.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. No, no, no. Yeah, in the topic. Yeah. Topic.
There's topic. Huawei, yeah. Canada.
Okay. Uh-huh. I know who would join that.
Okay. Mm-hmm. It's just a thought. Like, if we could start kind of showing up, even just from a CHAOSS perspective at some of these events and talking about the work that CHAOSS does. Features and add-ons. I don't evening. Oh, co-located events. So this is the, yeah, so they have all these co-located events as well. Mm-hmm. So this is also part of my thoughts as well around OSPOCon, but I mean, this is just one. I just picked this one. I also had there's something called Kubernetes Community Days that I'm not familiar with.
It's held in China, or
I think they're all so the I think they have different community days that can be in different regions of the world. Mm-hmm. You know, so like there'll be like a local Kubernetes community in, say, Seoul, and then there'll be another Kubernetes local community in probably Shanghai, you know, like just kind of all over the place. Mm-hmm. So that's how I understood community days. And then the last one was the to-do group. So we are, for those of you that don't know, the CHAOSS Project is joining the, or we have joined the to-do associates program. So we've been working pretty closely with Anna because a lot of open source program offices care about obviously the work that we do in the CHAOSS Project. Mm-hmm. So there is OSPOCon as well.
So I noticed that the value working group would focus on the to-do group related unit.
Yep. Yeah. Exactly.
So do you have any detailed collaboration content in this group?
At this point, the intention of the value group is to provide a working group that is a cross between CHAOSS and the to-do group, where to-do group members could specifically talk about metrics that they care about within their open source program offices. So it's pretty similar to the work I think that we're doing in the metric model working group, but the intention is to provide an hour, you know, or 50 minutes where members of the to-do group can participate directly with members of the CHAOSS community. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Particularly around metrics. So
we would produce some or create some metrics to focus on the corporations.
Yep.
Metrics, related metrics.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yep, that's okay. The intention of the value group now, which is now the OSPO working group. Mm-hmm. And so that's a potential as well.
Actually, I'm looking forward for that working group. It should be very meaningful.
I think so too. Mm. Yep. And that's the intention. It might take a little while. We talked to Anna that it might take a while to get the to-do group members to show up. You know, it's hard to add things to people's schedule, but the hope is that over the course of, a couple months, we can start building up presence of to-do group members in that new working group. Mm-hmm. Shoya, do you have a comment or question too? Shoya froze. I'm sorry. I waited too long to see what the comment was. When Shoya comes back, that's fine.
Yeah.
You know, does anybody have any, we can look here?
I'm thinking that how we can join from China.
Yeah, because right now the OSPO working group is at 11 a.m. US Central. So it's like 3 hours.
Yeah.
It's too not good for China.
Yeah, it should be 2 a.m. in China. Yeah,
that's no good. So, I mean, do we want to have, is it worth trying to coordinate, say, an OSPO working group in Asia Pacific that runs a team that's friendlier to, like, I would never be able to make it, you know, but it could be.
Maybe we can just let it go for a while. I mean,
okay.
So we haven't had our first meeting in this working group yet.
No, not really. I mean, we had the first one was technically 2 weeks ago, but it was like the first meeting. So we're building momentum on it.
Yeah. So we'll see. I will looking through the meeting minutes for the next meeting.
Okay.
And, if I found any interesting things or something that I would like to join, I will be there anyway.
Okay. Elizabeth, you have a comment? You're muted if you have a comment.
Yes, there we go. Okay. I had a question. Sorry, I had a question. And this is just my own ignorance shining through here. But is there any overlap between the things that InterSource folks would care about and the folks that OSPO folks care about? Like maybe there's a more of an InterSource spin on this?
Lot of things. We cannot see the overlap, but I would mention that actually many InterSource operated in the companies using the similar way in open source, and there have two purposes generally. First, there are a lot of softwares are common within the company, so they should set up such inner source, something like a platform tools in CI or DevOps. So they are running it as an inner source solution to provide common solution among the in the company. And there's another purpose for the inner source is that before they are going to plan to open source it, they would like to run it within the company. At the inner source, at the incubator. After they think it's good enough, and they would publish it as open source solution and run it through an open source community. So there are a lot of connections between the inner source and open source.
Oh, that's super helpful. Thank you very much, Yuhui. Is there any, so I remember like this group was really interested in inner source things earlier on. Is there any, if we can't connect with the to-do group and their meetings, is there any merit in carving out a piece of this meeting for OSPO / inner source conversations as we had done in the past or not?
I think we can involve it as a part of the topic in the OSPO working group. It should be very helpful for the OSPO people, because as I know that a lot of people from OSPO, they would like to connect, set up the connection between the inner source and open source. Even there, another case is that a product, part of that is running as inner source, and part of that is running as open source. That's the one scenario. So I do think the people in OSPO should focus on these two areas.
I know we've been packing a lot in these meetings because we're also talking about metrics models and the SaaS stuff and then all the stuff that's going on in China. So these meetings probably need to be about 4 hours long, but I guess it's okay. I guess it's all right.
Yeah.
So Elizabeth, did you see that as a way to include folks from other regions?
Yes.
Okay.
If we wanted to use the OSPO theme as a way, as a bridge.
Okay.
That was my only suggestion, is to like make this meeting also touch on that instead of having a whole separate meeting or something like that. I mean, that's also a possibility if we wanted to set up one more meeting at CHAOSS, because you know, we don't have enough. So we should have more.
Actually, this is not a secret that in my company, and I know in many other companies, they are using CHAOSS metrics and metrics model for their inner source solution, or even the productions, business production software to mirror their the whole things, because some productions product, I mean the software product in the company, they are running at open source way.
Mm-hmm. So how, okay, so if we did that, Elizabeth and Yui, mm-hmm. Like if we had this meeting be more focused, like I'm trying to think about how CHAOSS Africa is running. So CHAOSS Africa has kind of their own working group meeting that they run really just for people on the African continent. You know what I mean? Like, and it's just it's a meeting that, do you attend it, Elizabeth?
I do not, typically.
Yeah, I don't either, and I don't think Sean does attends it. You know what I mean? So it's a meeting that is like time friendly for a lot of the people in Africa, and it's about efforts that are occurring in Africa. And I'm wondering if there should be a CHAOSS Asia, this meeting that's currently at 8 a.m. our time and pretty late your time. Like if there could be, if this meeting could just be moved to a time that's friendlier for the Asia Pacific region. You don't expect me or Elizabeth or Sean to join, you know what I mean? But it's about thinking about events that occur in the Asia Pacific region. It's about initiatives in the Asia Pacific region. You know what I mean? Like it's kind of focused on efforts that may be occurring in that particular part of the world. We would still keep the metric model working group meeting, you know, which has a lot of attendees from China. We could include the inner source stuff with the value meeting and perhaps move that time around so that it's friendlier to folks in Asia Pacific as well. But I'm wondering if this meeting itself should be moved, like the Asia Pacific meeting should be moved to a time that's friendlier to people in the Asia Pacific region, and we wouldn't attend. We would get updates, you know what I mean, via Slack and stuff like that. But what do you, do you have thoughts on that, Yehui or Elizabeth or Liang or Shoya?
What do you think, Shoya? Because Shoya is community manager in Asia Pacific.
Can someone hear me now?
Yes. Yeah.
Hey. Okay. Hi. Well, I think it's a good idea, and I kind of know what CHAOSS Africa is running now. Well, I think the idea of like running CHAOSS Asia Pacific in a time zone friendlier to us, and the idea maybe is more about involve folks from not just Chinese speakers, but also like who speak Japanese and Korean, mm-hmm. and even India, and I think it's great if we can reach out. I'm not sure if I catch the topic what we that discussed around OSS Japan. Because earlier I just want to mention that I'm interested if we are going to like build build bridges collaborations with to-do group, and I'm interested in that too because I have hand around in to-do group before, and I'm also highly interested in like the stuff related with OSPOS, and also Anna has invited me to be one of the PC chairs to review the proposals of OSS Japan, I think, to expand the gender diversity in Asia Pacific with the OSPO representatives.
So that's great. So the idea with OSS Japan or Kubernetes Community Days or any event is, I think if we as the CHAOSS Project want to extend our presence in the Asia Pacific region, we have to knock on doors, so to speak. I don't know if that metaphor translates. You know what I mean? We will have to do the effort to go to these events or to reach out to individuals in India or in Japan or in China. And I think we'll have to do the work. So that was in OSS Japan. And I'm just thinking about how like CHAOSS Africa has done well and how CHAOSS did well originally. It was us going out to the member summit, to OSS Europe, to FOSDEM, to OSS North America, to All Things Open. You know what I mean? Like, we did a lot of the work to make sure that we had workshops, or to make sure that we had a birds of a feather session, or to make sure that we had tracks to talk about CHAOSS in front of the audiences that we wanted to reach out to. And so it would have to be, the idea here is that OSS Japan could be one of those locations where we go knocking on doors, so to speak. So that's all that was.
Yeah, I agree with that. So can we still submit proposals to OS Japan?
I don't.
Or is there another way? Because I know they have reviewed the proposals. So
yeah, I'm wondering if we could reach out to Shoya. Maybe you and I could just reach out to. I could send an email and CC you. And we could reach out to events, and we could just find out if there is, do you know what a birds of a feather session?
Yeah.
So they just, you know, they have a board, and you just put your topic on there, and whoever shows up. You know, perhaps we could do something like that at OSS Japan.
Okay.
You know, something a little bit informal this time, but maybe next time we could be more thoughtful about trying to actually submit a proposal.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. And we could also, I mean, it's possible that we could reach out, we could take a look at the Kubernetes Community Days. Again, I was just picking, and if there's other events, is there an open source summit India? Does the Linux Foundation run events in India?
I don't think there is. At least I haven't seen anything come through our badging, which most of those events do. But I'll keep an eye out.
Okay, because that would be. Is there anything in Australia?
No, I don't think so.
Okay. Okay. So it was an effort to kind of reach out and do a little bit more work in that regard. And then, Shoya, it seems like you would be okay with moving this meeting to a time zone that's a little bit more friendly for folks in the Asia Pacific region, where you could talk about submitting to these events, or you could talk about, you know, and then the idea is like with Ruth, Shoya, you know, like Ruth keeps us, she communicates with us to tell us what's going on in CHAOSS Africa. And we know you so well, it's easy to talk to you as well. You know what I mean? That it's easy to get an update from what's going on in this meeting.
Yes. And just one point I wish to mention is like Chaos Asia Pacific is for now it's more of Chaos China, you know. The folks we have on the meeting, we may find it more comfortable if we only have us. It's more comfortable to speak in Chinese, but we don't want to do that because we kind of want to involve. Yeah, because
yes.
I do think, I'm not sure what's the situation for folks in Africa, but I do feel that language is a huge barrier for the regions for Asians. So maybe that's also, one of the reasons it's hard to reach out to folks in Japan and in Korea and in India. India is an exception,
Okay, no, that could very well be the case. I mean, that you may be right on that. And we can try to find out, you know what I mean? We can try. If it doesn't work, that's okay.
Okay.
Great. So maybe, Shoya, I'll reach out, an action item. I can reach out to the events team here and see if there's a possibility to have an unconference or a birds of a feather session. And then maybe you could think about a time zone that would work better for you. And you think, a regionally time zone friendly.
Sure.
To where this meeting could be moved.
Yeah, I'm okay with that. And I also want to hear the thoughts of Ye Hui or Liang or Chen Qi.
About the time zone issue, I checked the internet and it's 10 p.m. now in Japan and Korea. And for Indian, let me see. And it's close to 7 p.m. in India. So I don't know, and maybe it's a bit late for people from Japan, maybe. So shall we move earlier or? Well, maybe 1 hour earlier.
I think we can check with the time differences among these countries: Korea, Japan, India, and China, of course. And I think the time differences is of course is a problem. It's a problem, but I do think. Compared with move the meeting to a comfortable time slot for the Asia Pacific, I prefer to define some focus point in the Asia Pacific meeting. So as I know, and in the past 2 years, we use this Asia Pacific meeting as a bridge between the people from China and the chaos community. That's the most important point we built. And the second value built by this working group is that we have made a matrix translation version in China, in Chinese. So any other point, And I'm thinking about that. Actually, I'm prefer to connect more people involved in chaos community from China, even we call it Asia Pacific. But I do think it's a little bit difficulties for involve people from other countries in Asia Pacific, like Japan, Korea, and for India. So. Maybe we can have a discussion with Xiaoya, with Matt, his beings, and Liang, to see how it's moving forward in this meeting.
Yeah, so I think I got that right. So just the challenge that could come from including other countries and then thinking strategically about how to do that. Is that the last point? Yeah. Yep. Okay. And I, you know, Anna, we might want to include Anna in that discussion, Yehui, from the to-do group.
Sure. Anna is a to-do group community manager, right?
Correct. Yep.
Yeah. I joined to-do group represent Huawei okay. a couple of times. But the meeting time slot is not that friendly.
See, this is the point. I'm trying to make it friendlier for folks in that region.
So that's why I just joined a couple of times.
Okay. So your suggestion, Yehui, is that if there is a move that is specific to or this time zone more time zone friendly, take a little bit of time to define. What the focus of that meeting would be about.
Yep.
Okay. And perhaps even like, I'm thinking maybe the bridge, if it is more time zone friendly, like we could have a weekly or biweekly meeting with Shoya to make sure that she can bring that information, you know, from the US meetings. So Elizabeth, do you have thoughts here as well? Kind of curious.
Yeah, I think that all makes sense. I think it all makes sense. I think it's just going to be like a learning experience for all of us to try to sort out, you know, how we're going to move forward. I'm a little bit concerned with trying to grow the community in all the places at once. So like India, Japan, Australia, like that's a lot. That's a lot for Shoya. So that would be my only concern, is that we maybe, you know, focus a little bit, like maybe just Japan first and then, you know, see how the community grows. And if there is, and, you know, maybe Chaos India, because we do have quite a few folks from India who join. So maybe that will be its own community also someday, like who knows, but yeah, I think it all makes sense.
Okay. That's great. And so if this meeting moves to be more time zone friendly, we would just collectively, I think we would keep the metrics model meeting where it is, correct? Mm-hmm. Agreed. And we would, to your point, Elizabeth, start talking about perhaps InterSource as well in the OSPO meeting, in the OSPO working group. That would not be a new meeting at this point. Elizabeth?
Yeah, that makes sense.
Okay. And if we're starting, I think Yehui was alluding to this, if we're starting to build momentum in the OSPO working group, perhaps at that point we could think about moving the time again back to say like this time, you know what I mean? Like we can move that, the old value working group such that it could possibly include OSPO representatives from.
If it's fun, I think we can merge two meetings into the one. I mean, yep. Asia Pacific meeting and together with the to-do meeting.
Okay.
Sorry, not to-do meeting, OSPO
working group. I got you. I understood what you were saying. Okay. Okay, so at this point, there's no new meetings. I think this is at least the proposal. And we can all sleep on this. We don't have to decide right now. But the proposal is to potentially move this meeting to a more time zone friendly time zone. Okay, cool. Okay, great. Thank you very much for that. This is just something that's been on my mind quite a bit. And Yehui, I will include Anna in this as well, because I'm suspecting she has some very good ideas in terms of how this works.
Yeah, because Elizabeth just shared a discussion link through the to-do group. I mm-hmm. noticed that there are some familiar people from China already start the discussion.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
So I think a lot of people from China are interested in this community collaborations between to-do and the chaos.
Okay. So this is great. And it's from Mark. Yeah, go ahead, Shoya.
Actually, I'm also wondering if this to-do to do Asia Pacific. I wonder if like possibly it could be merged with like CHAOSS Asia Pacific or other CHAOSS meeting, because I know currently this is a mostly meeting.
Okay.
And still it has some difficulty to push forward because just lack of, I think it's also lack of momentum, and gradually there is no like a few participants in every time on this meeting.
Okay. Well, maybe that's okay. Maybe that's good for us. Maybe like we could provide some of the momentum and get support from the to-do group to also advertise such a meeting. You know what I mean?
Yeah, because I know Anna, she was also seeking support to moderate this to-do Asia Pacific.
Okay. Well, why don't I'll start a separate thread maybe in Slack or something like that, that we can think about how to bring these together. And all of you maybe just think about this as well. So I think this is a big move and something that I'm pretty excited about. Yeah. All right. Yehui, did you have any updates on Compass that you wanted to share?
About Compass, actually, I prepare for the demo in the next metrics model meeting.
Okay.
And everything is before it's launched next month. So I think it's ready to show up a test version to everybody in CHAOSS community. So in that demo, I would like to invite all of you to start using this service and tell us your use experiences. Okay. And we can improve that.
Okay. I'll make sure to get that on the start of the schedule for the metrics model meeting, because that demo and conversation might take a while.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, great. Thank you. Anything else on that, Yehui, or is that, you're good?
We will provide a summit for the OSS Compass next month. So it's just a half day summit. So we are preparing for that. After we knock down the schedule, the detailed schedule, I would like to share with you that, because it is a face-to-face meeting. It is, but of course, it should be online stream video. So should it's open for everybody.
Okay. Where is it? Is it in Shanghai?
Not decided yet. We aimed in Beijing, but we will see.
Okay.
But we are checking the different options in Shanghai, in Beijing, or in Shenzhen.
Okay, cool. Sounds great.
Yeah.
That could also be another nice community building opportunity, kind of for the discussion we were having above. Yeah. All right, cool. Any questions for Yehui on Compass and the work that they're doing there? All right. I just had a few updates that I did want to share just from the CHAOSS project kind of at large. Shoya, you do know, but CHAOSS Africa is really doing amazing work. So we've had a lot of interest from newcomers in the newcomer channel from CHAOSS Africa. Ruth has been doing a really amazing job kind of coordinating activities, whether they're kind of meetups in Africa. She's also been doing a really good job at coordinating onboarding activities. This is something we probably want to talk about as well, Shoya. Just like what are the paths to include people from CHAOSS Asia Pacific. So right now in CHAOSS Africa, there seems to be a lot of interest around the badging work that we're doing, as well as there's a lot of interest in design work for the CHAOSS brand. Elizabeth, do you have other kind of thoughts on how people are joining and participating from CHAOSS Africa?
Yeah, they're very enthusiastic. they're coming in in waves. And just for as an example, we're we have the DEI event badging initiative where events can get a badge, and so each of those applications requires two reviews, and Shoy is on that team as well. We get floods in different parts of the year. So like September and October is a big one where we get a whole lot of applications at once. So we are doing a new class of badgers, and we have 10 people from CHAOSS Africa who are now signed up for
Crazy.
The orientation. Yeah, to be new badgers. So that's fantastic. And just as a point of context, I think we have maybe 12 people total on the team right now. So yeah, we'll essentially be doubling our team just from those folks. So yeah, they're very enthusiastic. And Ruth has been doing a fantastic job of pointing people in the right direction, which is really challenging sometimes when you're trying to figure out as a newcomer, where to put people and like where they belong. So she's been really great at trying to help them find their way.
Cool. Thank you. That's crazy that we might go from 12 to 22 mm-hmm. reviewers.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm excited. And I'm sure the reviewers who are on the team right now are also excited because they're getting a lot of applications right now. So yeah.
I know. So it made me think as you're saying this too, Shoya, this might be something to think about with CHAOSS Asia Pacific. Like, what are the paths to joining? So if somebody has an interest in China or Japan to join the CHAOSS project, like what is that interest? Is it to contribute to software? Is it to contribute to metrics model development? Is it to contribute to event organization? Like, are there particular things that people have an interest in as ways of joining the CHAOSS project? Because joining any open source project can be a bit overwhelming sometimes. And we're trying to find those paths that people can just begin to participate. And they may be different paths than CHAOSS Africa. And so we probably want to think about what those paths are. And this is to Elizabeth's point, like Ruth has done a really great job at kind of identifying what those lanes are, those paths are for people. And getting them to engage that way. So I'm not sure what the paths are for folks in China.
I'm not sure either. I think the main focus right now is the translation and metrics model, which okay. I think just metrics model might have a more steep pass to enter, but localization is maybe a better way for newcomers to get started.
Okay.
So people from Africa, CHAOSS Africa, they are coming to the different countries, right?
Yeah. So the probably the most represented country, I believe, is Nigeria.
Uh-huh.
But yes, all different countries in Africa.
They are speaking in English, right?
Yes, at least on the calls, yes. Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay, great. I did want to mention as well that we are starting to build out a program around project badging. So similar to event badging, we think we found a path forward that kind of accommodates the capacity that the CHAOSS project has. We are a limited set of people with only so much human capacity to provide support. This human capacity against in ability or inability sometimes to create tooling around DEI initiatives, that can be a challenge as well. In addition to kind of working with some of the big platforms, say for example, GitHub, how this could potentially fit with the infrastructure that they're doing. So It's been a, just like any project, you have a bunch of different stakeholders who have a bunch of different interests. And when you first look at all of those interests, it doesn't seem like it can come together ever. But over time, I think we're finding a path forward that works for everybody. And I feel like we're in a good spot right now to really move this forward positively. Elizabeth, did you have any comments on that as well?
It will be sort of similar to our DEI event badging, except for there will be more automation in the levels. So the human part, the human review won't be until like the fourth level. So it will work a little bit differently, but the concept is the same. We're basically wanting to have the projects reflect on how they're centering DEI in their own projects and basically just explain to their community and then kind of share that with us, the badging initiative, to just to clarify, you know, how they feel about the newcomer experience, for instance. So that would be the only difference, is that it's a lot more automated, but like to Matt's point, the scale is the issue. So hopefully it will all work out and not require any human intervention until the very end, but I guess we'll see how that goes. That's the goal anyway.
Actually, I have one topic. I pop up one topic in the DEI badging Slack channel, that if we could get the DEI badging evaluation result through any REST API, that we could add this result as part of the metrics model.
So that is now on the roadmap. So we've talked to Enoch about that, and I have a student here actually in Omaha who's mm-hmm. interested in that as well. So I think that should, I'll ping Enoch and see how that's going. Mm-hmm. But yes, it's something that we are working on now based on your feedback. Yeah. And I agree with you. I think even in the project badging, like one of the potential things is to see if a project has had an event that has been badged. Mm-hmm. You know, so it's certainly some data that we should be able to provide via an API.
Yeah.
Agreed. Okay, and then the last thing that I just wanted to mention before we head out for the day is that, you know, I just wanted to let you know that CHAOSS has joined the To-Do Associates program. So this is a good thing because metrics matter for OSPOs. But I also think, kind of per our earlier discussion, it could give us a way to kind of connect with existing infrastructure or existing meetings or existing resources or people, however we want to think about it, to kind of build momentum together with a very successful program that is the To-Do program. Mm-hmm. And so I'm pretty excited about that. And everybody that I've met has been great from the To-Do group. In fact, right now, I think Don Foster, Sean, and Daniel Esquerdo from Grimoire Lab are all in Stockholm, Sweden, giving talks at OSPology, one of the OSPO meetups by the To-Do group. So you can check that out as well. I think the talk is today, so if I'm not mistaken. So anyway, I'm really excited about that. And I think that's a good connection that we can make and help things here. So great. Look at that. We made it to the end. This is a really good conversation. I can't tell you how much I appreciate thinking through these things.
Me too.
It'll be beneficial for everybody. All right. So have a good evening, everybody in yep. China. Elizabeth, have a good day. Keep drinking.
Have a good coffee. Morning.
Yes.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Okay, take care.
Have a good day.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.